Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we're going to talk about the recommended upgrade path for your B58. So we're going to talk about basically the different stages or upgrades that you can do to your B58, and about how much power it can make, and kind of just help you plan out what you want to do with your build. If you kind of have an idea of how all this works, but you just want to see expected power outputs, I'll put that at the end of the video, and I'll split it up based on the fuel type that you're using and recommended upgrades to get you to 400. 500 and then 600 plus horsepower. So feel free to jump to the end of the video if that's your primary question or what you want to look at. So with the B58, it's not like typical turbo engines, and you're not going to need to do a lot of upgrades that are required for other turbo cars, primarily because our cars have an air-to-water intercooler, and also because it comes with an extremely efficient and capable cold air intake from the factory. So the first thing that you'll want to do is flash a stage one tune. And the stage one tune works with a completely stock car. You don't need to upgrade anything. You can basically just run your car as if it had a more powerful tune from BMW. So it won't make any extra noises. It won't have any weird smells or anything that can come with, you know, downpipes and exhausts and intakes. And in that case, your car will basically be just like stock. So I feel like that tune is really underrated. I ran stage one 93 and then a stage one E30 map for several months before I really started upgrading the car to make a lot more power. And it was great. I didn't have anything to worry about. It was very under the radar. I just could enjoy the car anytime I wanted to. Now, the next upgrade is going to be a downpipe, and this will set you up for what most companies call a stage 2 tune. And the stage 2 map is going to be pretty similar to stage 1, but it's going to update your fueling and your airflow and everything to account for the additional flow you'll get with your downpipe. It'll help spool the car up quicker, and it will help it hold a little more power to redline. So this will give you kind of a marginal gain as far as peak horsepower, but you should feel a pretty significant change when you're driving the car. So adding a downpipe will kind of give you a marginal change, especially when you're comparing it going from stage one to stage two, but it will help the car pull harder. You will see an improvement in your times because it helps the turbo spool faster, and it also helps it hold more power to redline. So that's a relatively cheap upgrade, especially if you can get away with a catless version to get a little more power out of the car. Now the next upgrade would be a high pressure fuel pump upgrade. And this will allow you, again, to turn up the boost, run a lot more torque in the mid-range, and a little more horsepower up top. The peak gains are actually in the mid-range because the turbo spools so quickly that the high-pressure fuel pump allows a lot more boost in the mid-range. But on the top end, the stock turbo still has a tendency to run out of steam. So a lot of times you'll see dynos that show huge gains between like maybe 3,000 and 5,000 RPM. But up top, you know, towards redline, the gains are kind of reduced. The car still does pull a lot harder, and just like when you add a downpipe, you'll see a noticeable improvement in your times. So pretty much at this point, you've achieved what the B58 version of an FBO or full bolt-on would be. You don't need an intake, you don't need an intercooler, a charge pipe, or heat exchanger. All you need are those three mods, a downpipe, a fuel pump upgrade, and a tune, and that'll pretty much optimize your stock turbo. You can always get a custom tune to squeeze a little bit more power out of it, especially if you don't have ethanol available and you want to run meth or something to help you get a little more octane in the car. But for the most part, it doesn't really make sense to get a custom tune unless you're really out to shoot some records or you're just hell-bent on staying with the stock turbo. But like I said, the stock turbo always kind of runs out of steam in the upper RPM, so you'll get a lot more torque in the mid-range as you upgrade your fuel pump and run different fuels, but the top-end power isn't going to change significantly. Now, once you're pushing above stage 2 power, you also need to upgrade your transmission. If you have an automatic trans, this is a good time to get the XHP transmission flash. It will allow you to increase the amount of torque that the transmission can hold, and it will also allow you to update your shift settings and basically optimize how the transmission works with your car. So that'll allow you to hold a lot more power without any issue. Now, if you have a manual transmission like me, it's a good time to upgrade your clutch. The recommended clutch upgrades are to go with the OEM clutch from a 335IS or 550i. It's the same clutch that people used to upgrade in their E90s, and it's pretty cheap, and it works great, and it drives just like stock. It just holds a lot more torque. Now after that, the next step is a bigger turbo upgrade, and that can easily push the car over 600 horsepower. Many people are running over 600 horsepower on the stock engine without any issues, Just make sure you have the appropriate fueling upgrades that you need and a good custom tune, and the car will run great. Now, even with a big turbo upgrade, the car tends to handle IATs very well, so you don't necessarily need an intercooler upgrade, but above 650 horsepower or so, a lot of people tend to see cracks in their intake manifold from the additional boost pressure. So it is recommended to upgrade your intake manifold above that point. Some people are getting away with it without any issues, but it's kind of hit or miss whether the car will be able to handle it or not. And if you crack your intake manifold, it's just going to cause a big boost leak. So you'll see a significant loss in power. And just to keep everything running well and not risk damaging anything, I would say that's a good time to start looking at intake manifold upgrades. Also, for people that are pushing above like 650 foot-pounds, it'll be time to build your transmission for the automatic transmission guys. The default upgraded transmission is made by Pure Drivetrain Solutions. So hit them up, get your trans upgraded, and that will allow you to hold 650 plus torque reliably without an issue. There are also some people that upgrade to the HP70 trans, which is a cheaper upgrade, and it's basically pulling a trans from the diesel version of our cars. It works and it does hold more torque, but it is an older technology. Some people have experienced slower shifts. There are also some challenges sometimes with getting XHP flash to work. So it just kind of depends, but for the people that are running it successfully, they highly recommend it and enjoy it. It really just depends on your budget and your needs. So yeah, those are the recommended upgrades. Now I'll kind of just post some charts at the end of the video so that you can get an idea if you're shooting for 400 horsepower, 500 horsepower, or 600 plus. This will kind of give you an idea for what modifications you need depending on the fuel that you're using. And hopefully that helps you kind of plan out your build so that you can hit your goals. But if you guys have any other questions or comments, feel free to leave them down below. Thanks.